coming up. We make some awesome bus bars that are both inexpensive and will carry all the load you need. Then, some very bad things happen. Hello and welcome to Fix Tech Stuff. In the previous video, we put ultra-convenient XT60 connectors on our charge controller. I connected a 12-volt 2000-watt inverter, one battery, installed solar panels, and pulled down a tree that was stealing all the sunshine. Let's make a set of copper bus bars complete with strain relief just like these. We'll start with some old copper 10mm or 3/8 water pipe. A few minutes of hammering it flat on the anvil and it should look like this. First I'll drill a hole in one end, making sure to leave enough room for washers and lugs. You can always trim it later. You'll need to bend it over your anvil or the edge of the bench. Use the hammer to help make those tight bends. We're almost there. Place one end over the battery terminal and mark the other. Now we'll drill both of those. Trim them to size. Now remove any burrs and round the edge on the bench grinder. There we have it. As I like to say, not pretty, but functional. It's not a good idea to have all that copper exposed for any metal objects to come in contact with, so a bit of heat shrink will take care of that. And finally, I just trim off the excess. This is a different set of bus bars made the same way. As we have a 12-volt inverter, we're configuring them in parallel. For two batteries and 24-volt, we'd only need one small bus bar. I'd already connected the second battery to make sure it was fully charged. No sparks or anything. Power on the inverter, and we're all good. Let's leave it all to charge to maximum capacity.
The next day.
Disaster. I came to check on it and found the battery was full, but it's not showing the correct voltage. After letting it drain down, it shows nothing and still won't charge. Then I heard a loud pop coming from the inverter. It's still running, but there must be a problem. Tune in next time as we find out the cause of this and come up with a solution. Thanks for watching.